What is up, guys? Jimmy or Chaos Silencer. Welcome to Walk and Talk Vlog. This is where I walk the streets and I talk to you. You're probably like, Jimmy, got the Grizzly Adams going on. I do. Big day today. Got videos to put out, got work to do. Got PTFO tonight. We have a cheeseburger challenge. Me and Kyle and Burns and Straight Up Knives. We're going to see who can eat the most McDonald's cheeseburgers in 5 minutes time. You guys be sure to tune into that. We're also giving away a copy of Borderlands 2, for any system. So it should be pretty cool. And I was reading the comments on the last vlog, and I told you guys to be interactive and give me stuff you wanted me to talk about. And somebody wanted me to talk about my biggest adversity as a parent. And I thought, you know what, that's a good one. And I've told this story before, but I'll make it quick. But if I think back and I think, well, you have to have a lot of patience to be a parent, for sure. But the biggest adversity would be my three-year-old son, Dylan. A lot of you know him. You've seen him on videos before. He had open heart surgery when he was 6 months. So we have Dylan, and everything's okay. And we're like, yeah, this is awesome. He goes for his checkup, and the doctor's like, well, there's some heart murmurs. And so this doesn't really click in me that would be anything serious. Okay, he's got some heart murmurs. What does that mean? Well, we're going to go have him check out a specialist. And I was like, okay, specialist. So then we go there, and they're like, well, yeah, he has tetralogy of flow, I believe is how you say it. Not for sure. Here comes a car, truck. And it turns out that is where he has holes in his heart, in his valves. And I didn't realize it was such a big deal. It was a huge deal. He ended up having to have open heart surgery. And that was the biggest test as a dad for me. Just being in a position where your six-month-old baby is under the knife and there's nothing you can do about it, it was crazy. I'll tell you real quick, after the surgery, I got to go into the room and he was in there, and I remember, he's like 6 months old, and he literally had 40 or 50 hoses and wires attached to him and everything, and he was all swollen. It was one of the most horrible visual experiences I've ever seen in my life. And I lasted about 10 seconds. And lasted about 10 seconds, and then I went out in the hall and basically hit the floor. I got overtaken with emotion, and I just couldn't stay in there and look at him like that. And I will say this, the people at Children's Hospital, they definitely, there's a higher calling for why they do their job. They don't just do it for a paycheck. They do it because they want to help. You can tell that, you can feel that genuinely in how they act and how they treat these kids. It was amazing. But yeah, that's the biggest test of fortitude I've had as a parent. And don't get me wrong, I've had all kinds of other things with kids. Kids getting hurt, you got to be patient. Training them, potty training, just everything else that across the spectrum of being a parent. But that one, I've said it a lot of times, don't take life for granted. Don't take any moment or any day for granted, because you never know what's going to happen. I had no clue that they were going to say, hey, your little baby has holes in his heart and he has to have open heart surgery and you're going to be in this hospital for a month. And you go in there and then you really get a perspective of people that go through stuff. You see kids in the burn unit, and it's just, it really opens your eyes to be grateful for what you have. And everybody always asks me, like, the baby we're gonna have coming up. Everybody's like, well, what do you want, a boy or a girl? And I just want a healthy baby. That's it. I don't care if it's a boy or a girl. I want Ashley to be healthy. I want the pregnancy to go smooth, and I want a healthy baby. That's all I want. And yeah, so there. That's my story of probably the hardest part of being a parent, the hardest moment I've had. Dylan's awesome. He'll be 4 in December. You couldn't tell. Dude is just full of energy. I'll try to get him on a video soon. He's been on one in the past, or a couple of them. And everything's great. Like I said, the people at Children's are amazing. Miracle workers. That's what they really are. But yeah. What I want you to get out of this, I'm going to try to give you something to get out of each one of these vlogs, is don't take life for granted. Live in the moment. Don't worry about what tomorrow has in hold for you. Worry about today. Focus on today and the fact that you have air in your lungs you have people that love you, and yeah, that's pretty much it. I hope that's not too corny. And that's the vlog for today. Hope you guys enjoy, and I will see you Friday. I didn't lose as much breath this time. This is working. Peace.